how to make a balance between the theory and practicals. Obviously, you know, paper one includes practicals, but you have to notice. Hello everyone, welcome to Plutus IAS. I'm C. Sonali Jindal. Today we will discuss the Commerce and Accountancy optional paper, paper 1 syllabus, and we will also try to see the strategy to prepare it. Firstly, in the paper 1, there are basically two parts are being asked. In first part, three subjects are being tested. One is accounting, second is taxation, third is auditing. And the part B test the financial management and financial institutions. Obviously, if you have decided to take the Commerce and Accountancy optional, you must have seen the paper. In example, basically 250 marks paper 1 is being asked, and it is further divided into two parts. One is part A and part B. First, four questions are given in the part A, and likewise from 5th to 8th question is given in the part B. 1st and 5th question is compulsory. Thereafter, you have to write 3 more questions, but you have to choose at least one question from one part. So my suggestion is, like, you can cover the part B more holistically. Thereafter, you can decide to write 2 questions from the 6th, 7th, 8th question, because the covering the financial management and financial institution takes less time. So you can score your 150 marks by preparing the part B. Now we will see the micro list in the subjects. So we have decided the priority, like, we will prepare FM, then FI. It will give you 150 marks. Thereafter, by seeing the marks distribution in the various years, the trends, after seeing that, I would suggest you focus on cost counting first, and then to the financial accounting, then to the taxation, and then auditing. You have to decide your priority while preparing, because if you will just go and start reading, you will end up wasting your time. Now, I want to give you the strategy, how to prepare, how to make a balance between the theory and practicals. Obviously, you know, paper 1 includes practicals, but you have to notice practicals maximum you can attempt of only 105 marks. I have seen mostly students are able to attempt of 190 marks. So in theory, you can see around 145 to 175 marks you can score through the theory, and theory takes obviously less time. In the practical, obviously there is a need of accuracy. Only one thing can happen in practicals. It can be right or wrong. There is no scope of margin, but yes, there is somehow stepwise marking. But there also that step needs to be accurate. So my suggestion is to focus on the theory, because you can score at least 150 marks. After discussing the strategy and priority to prepare, let's see the micro list, because everyone keeps looking at the broad subject, cost, accounts, but you have to see the micro list. In fact, even if you're preparing or taking any of the optional subject, you should see micro lists so that you can decide which topics need to be prepared. Because otherwise, if you will take the any book in the market, you will prepare all whole subject. But UPSC has clearly given the syllabus. Let's see financial accounting. In this, first line says accounting as a financial information system. Now, for the theory, you should have at least one pager notes for every topic. So that if the direct question comes from the topic, you are able to write that. In fact, if you will see the previous year questions, there are questions from the direct, like how will you define as accounting as a financial information? Then the next part is impact of behavioral sciences. Instead of looking at accounting subject, you should see the micro list. And third category I would categorize is accounting standards. There are around 12 accounting standards you need to prepare. Obviously, if you will see the ICAI material, there are many accounting standards, but the UPSC has listed only 12 accounting standards need to be prepared. And counterpart, now you have to prepare in AS as well. These are basically derived from the IFRS. Then the next topic is accounting for the share capital transactions. Obviously, if you are opting for the commerce and accountancy, you must have taken the commerce in 11th, 12th, or maybe you have done the BCom. This is of only 12th level. And in that also category has been created bonus shares, right shares, ESOPs and buyback. In this, focus on the accounting part and also prepare one pager theory note, because they can ask about the significance or impact of thereafter on the company or on the shareholder or on the economy. And then it is asking the company final accounts preparation and presentation. Here you have to prepare the schedule 3. As per Companies Act 2013, you have to prepare the new schedule and then amalgamation, absorption and reconstruction. My suggestion is, instead of solving the practicals of this chapter, try to focus on the theory, because it will take huge time in the exam hall. Because all, if you have appeared for the CA, there we get the time specifically for the accounts, but in the commerce and accountancy optional paper, you will get only 15 minutes to solve one numerical question. But if in between you realize that it is not right, then you will end up wasting your time. So try to focus on the theory first. I've already said around 150 marks you get the theory in the paper 1. Then the cost accounting, they have clearly categorized nature and function of the cost accounting, and the second part is installation of the cost accounting system. This is very basic. Main chapter starts from the cost concepts. They have clearly defined income measurement, profit planning, cost control and decision making. Then methods of costing, job costing, process costing and ABC. Consider them as separate chapters. Try to prepare one pager notes each for each of them. And in fact, I have seen the trend, whenever any topic is placed together, UPSC asks difference between them. So try to prepare definition, because there are questions that ask definition based, and then difference is being asked if the two topics are placed together. You can see the previous year question, difference between job and process costing has already been asked. Then the topic is volume cost profit relationship as a tool of the profit planning. It's already been there. Then incremental analysis, differential costing. Differential costing, tools of pricing decisions, product decisions, make or buy decisions and shutdown decisions. You should see the micro list. Like for example, if this chapter is being given in the 50 pages, you might read 40 pages, but you leave the topic shutdown decisions, then it will not be helpful to you. You should see the micro list given in the syllabus, because syllabus is real guidance to prepare. Then techniques of the cost control and cost reduction. As I've already said, if two topics are placed together and the AND word is used between the two topics, UPSC asks the difference. And in fact, cost control and cost reduction is already, the difference has already been asked. Then the budgeting as a tool of the planning. Direct questions has been framed from the syllabus lines. You should see previous year questions. That will obviously guide how to analyze the syllabus. Then the standard costing and variance alliances. Then the theory part comes of responsibility accounting and divisional performance measurement. consider them as a separate chapters so that you could prepare one page notes for each of them. Then comes the taxation part here, income tax definitions, basis of charge and income which do not form part of the total income. Why I'm showing you the specific topics so that you should know like which topics needs to be prepared. If you will just see income tax, then you can find out the reference books in the market, but you will not be able to decide which topics to be prepared and in which depth. Then it is asking about the competition of income. You need to focus, the only competition is being asked for the individuals only. It is not asking about the businesses. Then under various heads, the various heads been given. Then income from other persons included in the assessee's total income. So it is asking about the clubbing. You need to prepare two page notes for each topics and also solve numericals for the taxation. For, obviously, I have already told you the priority you have to maintain in the paper one, because taxation needs more holistic practice, and obviously in the exam hall you don't know, they might ask about the salary, house property or any of the topic, but I would suggest you to focus more on the salary and house property. These are more favorite topics of the UPSC. Then set off and carry forward of losses, then deductions. For every topic you need to prepare one page theory and also focus on how it will be deducted from the total income, because if even if you get the salary question or the house property, these top two topics can be clubbed in the final numerical question. So try to focus on more on these. And then salient features of the provisions relating to the service tax and VAT. Obviously, when the syllabus was basically made, GST was not there. Now for the indirect taxes, they can ask about the GST, and in fact they have already asked about it. So with the one page note of VAT and service tax, also prepare the GST. Then part A, last part, is auditing. They have given company audit. Here you need to decide your priority because it is a vast topic, but at least see previous year questions to decide which topics are more significant. Then divisible profits and dividend. From the divisible profits, you provide the dividend. And then the special investigation. Here different subjects or topics needs to be dealt with, like special investigation maybe for the incoming partner or maybe by the bank. Different topics needs to be taken. And then the cost audit. The next part is audit of various organizations. One is banking and the other one is insurance. Then is non-profit organization and the charitable trust organizations. Please look at the micro topics. Then coming to part B, financial management. Here the first chapter is finance function. Now I want to tell you financial management. Try to categorize it like this. One function is finance function. Basically, you make the financing decision, like from where you will get the money. Like it may be you are sourcing from the equity or debt. Then you are making the dividend decision, like whether dividend needs to be declared by the company or not. And then the final investment decision. It could be short term and it could be long term. In the short term, we see working capital management, and in the long term, you see capital budgeting. If you have understood that topic, then whole syllabus is clear to you. One is tool of financial analysis, ratio analysis, funds flow statement, cash flow statement, you have seen capital budgeting, cost of capital for the financing decision, and then the theories of the capital structure. dividend decision, working capital management, and the corporate restructuring and the focus. This topic needs to be prepared for the theory. The last topic is financial markets and financial institutions. If you will understand the Indian financial system, there you understand there are financial markets. It could be capital market or money market. Here it is money market and capital market. Then there are financial services that are mutual fund, venture capital, credit rating agencies and insurance. Then you need to read financial market instruments. They have already mentioned it. And the other one is innovative debt instruments. And there are financial regulators. They have mentioned IRDA, SEBI and RBI. So we have discussed all the syllabus of paper 1. We have already discussed about the priority and strategy. Hopefully it will help you. Thank you.